Hello students, I am Mr. Vijay from Pusat Vishwanathan. Now I am going to solve a question for you from the chapter of straight line. Now all please pay attention. Now this is the graph given to us. Alright, now this is line PQ. P is lying on x axis and the point of P will be 6, 0. Agree on students? And point Q is lying on y axis and there is another line here which is QR. And the equation for line QR is 3y equals to, what is this here?
4y.
Sorry, 4y, thank you. 4y is equals to 3x plus
12.
4y equals to 3x plus 12. And there is another line here, SR. This line SR is parallel to line PQ. Agreeable or not, students? Yeah. Okay, the first question. Now, before we go to the question, this is a huge problem among many students. Do you agree with me now? Yes, straight line is a big problem among students. Don't worry, I'll explain to you in an easy manner for you to understand. Okay, students, number one, the question is asking us to find PQ, equation of PQ. Is it correct now?
Yes, sir.
Alright, students, if I want to find equation of PQ, I just want to ask you that. My dear, to find a straight line equation, what do you need? Very good. Very good. And I heard many of you telling out there, very good, yes, it's true. You need only two things, yes, to find an equation of a straight line. You need two things, yes. One is what? Gradient, and another one is what? One point. You need 1 point. That means what? X, Y. Can you see that now? You only need these two. Okay, now, my question, do I have a gradient? Oh no! They asked us to find what? The equation of line what? PQ. Do I have a gradient? No, I don't have. Now if I don't have a gradient, then I must go to next condition, rule number two. Rule number two, this is rule number one. Now rule number two, if I don't have a gradient, then I must have 2 points. Because with 2 points, I can find what? Gradient. Can you see that now, student? So now come back here, student. I got 1 point. I want to find the equation of PQ. I got 1 point. Another point don't have lah. But they have given us the equation of line what? QR. What is the equation of line QR, students? It's already given to us. What is that? 4y equals to 3x plus 12. Correct answer? Now, actually what is this? Y-intercept of this line. Yes or no? How do I find y-intercept? I change this form into what? Y equals to mx plus c. Remember what, students? C is my what? Y-intercept. Very good. I heard many of you are telling that. Wonderful. So, what do I do now, students? For me, many of you, straight away, what we will do? What is my y-intercept, students? 12. Correct enough? Wrong. This is what majority of you will do. Remember, students, in this form, y equals to mx plus c, what is the coefficient of y? What's the number in front of y? But here is what? You got to change this. How do I do that? Divide everything by 4. So what do I get here? Y. Because 4 divided by 4 is 1. And over here, 3 over 4 plus 12 divided by 4 is how much, students?
3.
Very good. Now this is y equals to mx plus c. Can you see that? So what is my y-intercept, students? What's my y-intercept now? 3. So y intercept is 3, that means what is my point Q now? Point Q is 3, 0. Wrong. 0, 3. 0, 3. My point Q is what, students, again? 0. I put it here, 0, 3. Because my x is 0, my y is 3. So it must be 0, 3. Got it, student? Now I have 2 points. Can you see it now? I have 2 points. You got it? Now, how am I going to find? They asked me to find what the equation of PQ, right? I'm going to show you two ways. I'm going to show you the hard way, then I'm going to show you the easy way. Alright, now let's take a look. Students, all of you all pay attention. Now, what is the hard way? Now, difficult way, difficult method. Now, method number one, student, is like this, student. What I have to do, student? I have to find what? Gradient of PQ, right now. So, my gradient of PQ is equals to, I use what formula? Y2 minus Y1 over X2 minus X1. I heard many of you saying that, very good. So quickly, what do I do? I call this x1, y1. I call this my x2, y2. Now, if some of you might ask me, teacher, can I call this x1, y1? And can I call this x2, y2? By all means, it's up to you. Tak ada masalah. Whichever you want to call x1, y1 or x2, y2 is up to you. Are you okay now? So, since I already called this x2, y2. Wait. Here. So, y2 minus y1. What is my y2 student? Come on.
3.
And what is my y1 student?
0.
Very good. So, I put here 3 minus 0. And what is my x2 student? What's my x2 here, student?
0.
And what's my x1 student?
6.
So, 0 minus 6. Got it, student? So, what do I get here, student? 3 minus 0. Very good, 3. 0 minus 6. Negative 6. So, what's my answer here?
Negative
2. So, that's student. Correct, huh? But if those of you who are good, you already know what form is this, student? What
sure.
form is this?
Sure.
Yes.
Isn't it
negative 1 or 2? Yeah, thank you. You must simplify. Brilliant. Sorry. Forgive me. 3 over negative 6. So, negative 1 over 2. Because 3 and 6 simplify 1, 2. Thank you. Alright. Now, come back here again. Alright. Now, if you take a look here, why this form is what? Y-intercept. Okay? And remember, the gradient to find in y-intercept, let's say this is B. And this is, let's say this is A. This is B. What's the formula? Negative b over a. The y divided by the
x.
So, straight away, what is my y?
3.
Yes, if you take a look here, my y is actually what again? Very good, 3. And what is my x now here?
6.
So, I can use straight away here, negative 3 over 6. And I will get what? Negative 1 over? Can you see? Also correct. But which one is easier, students? Do you agree with me or not? This is much easier because straight away you know the formula. Alright? Now, second part, what must I do? Find the equation. So, what's the equation, student? Y equals to mx plus c. Correct, student? So, if I use y equals mx plus c, y equals to, what's my m, student? Gradient, what's the gradient?
Negative 1 over 2.
Wonderful. X plus. Student, c is what? Y intercept. Where is it cutting and y exists, student? Just now, we already find already. 3. So I straight away substitute 3. Correct enough, student? You can leave the answer like this. Or if you don't want to leave the answer like this, you want to multiply everything by 2 to get rid of the denominator 2, can also. So what do I get here? 2y is equivalent to negative times x is negative x plus 3. You want to leave the answer like this also, can? Or you can put it in this way, bring it over there. Negative x bring there becomes what? Plus x equals to 3. You can also do this, no problem. It's also accepted. But this is the difficult way or longer way. I'm sorry.
The 2 times y. Yes.
Sorry.
The
1
over
2. Yes, good. Since I multiply by 2, right? Then this one multiply by 2, this one multiply by 2, and this one also must multiply by 2. Thank you. So what is this here? 6. Correct, no? Very good. So if this is 6, then what here becomes, students? Also 6. Very good. You are very alert and aware. Wonderful. Good. I tested you for your alertness and you got it. Wonderful. Now I want to give you another important step. I am more concentrated in the other step. This is the longer way. What's the easier way, student? Remember, student, in my previous lesson, I have taught you this method. If you still remember, can you see now? Over here, this is the B, this is the A. What is this form called? Intercept form, correct? Na? If intercept form, straight away, X over, in this case, what here? B plus, I tell you what, I shall not confuse you. Let's stick to the same alphabet as what I've given you earlier. Let's change this to A and let's change this to B. So it becomes much easier for you. Okay? Now, where does this line cut at X axis? Where? A. So, it becomes what? X over A. You got it, students? X over A plus Y over, where it cut at Y axis, student? B equals to 1. Can you see that, students? So, I shall use this same concept over here now. I shall use the same concept. Where is it cutting at X axis, students?
6.
Where is it cutting at Y axis, students? 3. So, x over 6 plus y over 3 equals to 1. Can you see that answer? Now, I want to get rid of this denominator 6 and 3. I go to the bigger one. Which is the bigger one? 6. So what do? I multiply the whole equation by 6. Can you see or not? So 6 times this, the 6 and the 6 cut off. So remaining what student? X. Plus 6 and 3. What happened student? Cut off here 1. Here become 2. So what do I get here? 2y. Agree or not student? And 6 times 1. What do I get student? 6. Wow! Can you see? Is this answer and this answer the same not student? Which do you feel much easier student? Long method number 1. Short method number 2. Short method number 2, right? Because here 2 steps. Here is 2 steps. You find the gradient, then you substitute. But here 1 step is ready, we can find. Can you see that now? So in maths, there are more than one way to solve the question. There are more than one. Can you see that now? So it's up to you which method you feel easier. So this is Mr. Vijay from Sub-Vision Rakar. I hope you have benefited from what I taught you. Thank you, students. Bye-bye.